one sacrifice was good for all time. And if we want to understand how powerful that sacrifice is, I think you can look at the evidence, the historical evidence that we see to this day of how powerful that sacrifice is. When the Hebrews writer wrote this, it wasn't 7 years. It was 7 years later that the temple people would go to for sacrifice was leveled. For 2,000 years, there is no temple to make a sacrifice at. You can go there to this day and you can just see the ground of the temple, but you can't see any buildings, you can't see any altar for a sacrifice. Well, not only is there no temple, but for almost 2,000 years, there has been no high priest to bless the sacrifice. We see that to this day. There is the Jewish religion, but there's no high priest. To this day, you can go to Israel and you will not find a king. There is no king ruling over Israel for almost 2,000 years. And it makes me think, is this just a coincidence? That the sacrifice is made and not long after that, the prediction that Jesus said, that there would be no more temple, comes to pass in their lifetime? There's no temple, no high priest, no king. Unless, when we get here on Sundays, we are the temple that the Spirit of God dwells in. And unless, when we get here on Sundays, we attend a dinner, a supper, with the high priest as our host, who gives us the body and the blood. And unless we recognize there's a king that is waiting for us to one day take this Lord's Supper with him together in heaven. For 2,000 years, that hasn't been happening over in Jerusalem, but it's been happening all over the world. That's pretty good evidence in my mind.